Hello student, very good morning to all of you. I hope you all are happy, healthy and fine at home. Do you remember what were we discussing yesterday? I think we were discussing about the pinacle-pinaculon rearrangement reaction. What are the starting material? What is the reaction condition and what is the required product is obtained in pinaculon-pinaculon rearrangement reaction. What are the reaction condition? How the certain observation can be drawn from a pinacle-pinaculon rearrangement reaction? That kind of the thing we have discussed in our previous lecture. In pinacle-pinaculon rearrangement reaction mainly occur in a 1-2 diose or hydroxyl group present at 1-2 position, and then after the rearrangement reaction we are getting either ketone or the aldehyde depending upon the what kind of the starting material or the vicinal diol. So accordingly we are getting, and likewise we have studied that pinaculon-pinaculon rearrangement reaction. What we are going to discuss today is, let us see over here, today we are going to discuss about Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. Fevronsky rearrangement reaction means what? What does it mean? Fevronsky is the name of the scientist. He discovered this reaction first time, and therefore the name is given to this rearrangement reaction is known as a Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. And let me tell you the again, rearrangement reaction means what? A reaction in which a carbon skeleton or the functional group or both are modified is known as rearrangement reaction. And this is one of the very good example, a very beautiful example of rearrangement reaction is a Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. And in a Fevronsky rearrangement reaction, the Fevronsky rearrangement reaction is principally a rearrangement of cyclopropanone and alpha haloketone, which lead to the carboxylic acid derivative. Carboxylic acid derivative is known as Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. So this is about the Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. And now in a Fevronsky rearrangement reaction, just now we have seen the starting material required for this is alpha haloketones. Alpha haloketone generally treated with the base, and the cyclopropanone formed as an intermediate, and that either hydroxyl amine as a nucleophile or alkoxide as a nucleophile, they attacking to the site which is less substituted, and the resulting compound obtained or formed is the carboxylic acid or the ester. And during this process, suppose there is a ring formation, a ring contraction takes place. So that type of the reaction is known as Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. This is all about the Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. And let us see the general example of that Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. Let us see here. Look at here carefully, or observe this structure carefully. Here a C double bond O, and at this chlorine group which is present adjacent to the carbonyl group which is termed as alpha, and this compound when treated with as a base, as we know that it can act as a nucleophile and a base, they are having lone pair or carrying as a negative charge. That type of the organic species are known as base. And after treating this compound with base, the resulting compound form will be this one. Here there is a contraction of this ring. Look at, observe this starting compound or the substrate. It is a six membered ring. And now if you observe the product over here, you will see there is a ring contraction and carboxylic group is formed over there. And so this type of the rearrangement reaction is known as Fibrovsky rearrangement reaction. This is a general rearrangement reaction of Fibrovsky rearrangement reaction. Now let us look at as a mechanism, and as we know that mechanism is a language of organic chemistry. If you know the language, you can express your thoughts or you can express your feelings in a better way. So in the organic chemistry, if you know the mechanism, on the basis of the mechanism you can predict the product perfectly or very precisely or very confidently. So that is the reason behind it, because mechanism is a logical process where you can do very what we can call it as a perfectly, and then resulting compound will be the in a sequentially obtained is known as a mechanisms are there. And now let us look at here the mechanism, actually how the mechanism is takes place over here. Let us have this compound once again here, C double bond O, then Cl. This is alpha chloro cyclo penta cyclohexanone. This is alpha chloro cyclohexanone. So this is the name of this compound. And when the base like as a sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide is used, so what it will happen, this will abstract the highly acidic proton. And do you remember, adjacent to the carbonyl group, whatever protons are present, whatever hydrogens are present, they are highly acidic in nature, and by using as a base, preferentially base will abstract the proton from the adjacent to that carbonyl group. And when that proton get abstracted, that proton leaves its bonding pair left on that carbon atom, and the charge present on that carbon atom or that carbon atom carries as a negative charge, and that type of the species is known as a carbanion. And that carbanion, as we know that carbanion is well stabilized due to the presence of the carbonyl group adjacent to that negatively charged species. Now this negative charge, what is happening, look at carefully. The important step involved in a Fibrovsky rearrangement reaction is this one. Now this negative charge now attacking to that halide group, specifically in this particular example, attacking on that carbon atom which carries chlorine atom, and that chlorine atom get departed and form the important intermediate over here like this. This is a three membered cyclopropanone type the ring is formed over there, and this is an intermediate form here, intermediate form in this case. And as we know that this intermediate is highly unstable in nature, because due to the angle of strain, three membered ring is a very strained system over there. And now after that, OH minus is going to attack. There are two sides are available of attacking that hydroxy group, because both the sides are identical, similar, and therefore OH can attack either this side or this side. It never make the difference in this reaction, because the resulting compound is obtained is the same. And so for sake of convenience, and if the substituted, I will explain that point later on. So where it is attacking on that cyclopropanone, there are the two sites are available of attacking nucleophile. Nucleophile can attack on this carbonyl group, and then this lone pair, bonding lone pair is revolving around it, and that retain that carbon-carbon double bond, and this the sigma bond which is broken and form as a negative charge on this carbon atom, and so that you are going to get the product is like this over here, C double bond O, then OH minus, and now is a negative charge over there, and that negative charge again will pick up the proton from water during the workup, and what the resulting compound is obtained is a 5-membered ring. This is C double bond O, and the OH, that is a cyclopentane carboxylic acid. The compound is obtained cyclopentane carboxylic acid. This is the product obtained during this process, and this mechanism is known as Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. Look at once again, the mechanism is so simple. Once you listen or once you observe this mechanism carefully, what I did over here, look at here, OH minus will pick up the acidic proton, highly acidic in nature, adjacent carbon atom carrying as a 2-proton over there, and this proton is highly acidic in nature, and therefore carbanion will form over there, and this carbanion is going to attack on that chlorine atom. 3-member type of the cyclopropanone form as an intermediate in a Fevronsky rearrangement reaction, and that species become as a strain intermediate, and now the OH minus attacking on that carbonyl carbon, and that cyclopropanone ring get opened, forming as a carbanions once again. That negatively charged will pick up the proton from the solvent, particularly from water, and the resulting compound obtained is a carboxylic acid. So that is a required product obtained during this reaction, which is known as a Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. Understood? This is one of the best example of that what we can call it as a aromatic Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. Let us look at as another example over here. That example will give you the clear idea regarding again as a Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. Let us see the application of the Fevronsky rearrangement. Just now we have seen the general rearrangement reaction of Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. Now we are actually going to start, or we are going to learn some of the application of Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. Number of example we are going to take over here, that is nothing but as a application of the Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. Let us look at once again the example. Here example, these are nothing but as a application of Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. Now let us see over here, once again I am taking as a another example C double bond O, then here CS3, and now I am taking as a one of the chlorine atom, either either this side or this side. Let me take as a chlorine atom, maybe as a this side. So what is going to happen after this one? Now let us look at as a this example, and now I am treating this compound with that sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, which is generally employed or used in a Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. Now the first of all, let us see, predict the product. Now by looking, by observing this starting compound, you may get here the compound where we can get this type of the product, six membered ring, and then here maybe as a C double bond O, OH, and then let us see here is a CH3. This type of the compound is formed, that is a 1-methyl cyclopentane carboxyl acid. This is the possibility, or I can say this is a probable structure of this Fevronsky rearrangement reaction. Let's have the mechanism once again, then we can get the clear cut idea how we obtain these type of the product. Now let us see once again here this one C double bond O, then here CH3 Cl, that is a 2-chloro 2-methyl cyclopentanone 2-chloro 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, that is a generally numbering system I am using over here according to as IUPAC. So here at two position there is a chlorine group as well as methyl group is present at a two position, and therefore the IUPAC name of this compound will be 2-chloro 2-methyl cyclohexanone. So this is the IUPAC name of this compound. Now let me write as a mechanism over here. There is a hydrogen atom which is a highly acidic in nature as compared to the other proton which are present in this particular structure. Now that OH minus ion, that is a nucleophile, can attack on that proton, get abstracted, leaving the bonding prey left on that hydrogen atom, and the resulting compound will be obtained is this one. Here is a chlorine atom, that methyl group and minus charge over there, and after that this negative charge is going to attack on that carbon atom bearing the chlorine atom, and that chlorine atom get depart, and the compound obtained which is a cyclopropanone as an intermediate over there, here particularly as a methyl group here, and now the OH minus is going to attack over here. Now the question arises, where that OH minus going to attack, whether it is going to attack either this carbon atom or this carbon atom, this carbon atom bearing the methyl group, whereas this carbon atom bearing the hydrogen atom. Remember one point over here, the nucleophile is going to attack to the cyclopropanone intermediate to those side which is less hindered or less substituted. Now if you compare between this, this is the more substituted, highly substituted, whereas it is a less substituted, and therefore preferentially the hydroxyl group must attack on that carbon atom and not on this carbon atom. Do remember this thing in my now. Sorry, this is going to attack on that, not on this side. This hydroxyl group is going to attack on that carbonyl group. Let us see over here, and now then this bonding pair is revolving around oxygen atom, double bond get retained as it is, and this cyclopropanone ring get opened, and the resulting compound is obtained will be this one 5-membered ring, then here C double bond O, OH, and the methyl group is at which side? The methyl group should remain here, CH3 And now the negative charge over here, and that negative charge will pick up the proton from water solvent, and the final product obtained will be this one, C double bond O and this CH3. So this is the product which we got over here. So this is the product obtained in this reaction, and this is the example, best example of that Fieruski rearrangement reaction. And from that you can clearly understood that the what kind of the intermediate form in Fieruski rearrangement reaction, and the cyclopropanone ring gate open, in which manner preferentially stereospecific reaction, because the nucleophile is going to attack on that carbonyl carbon, and the ring gate open from the least substituted side. So that is the main point you should remember as far as the Fieruski rearrangement reaction is concerned. Let us take the another example of Fieruski rearrangement reaction. From that you can get the clear idea again for Fieruski rearrangement reaction. Let me take one more example over here. Here let us see C double bond O, then see, let us see over here, here is a chlorine atom, then I am taking here R1, R2, R3, then R4. These are the some substituent present over there. How they are going to react over here, that we are going to see over there. And now when it is treated with any kind of the base, so the resulting compound obtained will be this one, R1 C double bond O, C double bond O, then not R1, that is what we can call it as we are going to get this compound will be like this, suppose as a R2, then here R1, then C double bond O, OH, and then here may be this one R3 and R4. That type of the compound may obtain in this particular reaction. So let us see how we can get this type of the product. Let us see the mechanism over here, and from the mechanism we can get as a very clear cut idea about this. Now let us look at, once write down this structure once again, here R3 R4, here is R1 R2, and here chlorine atom or halide atom, you can take it here, you can take it as a X over there. Now when base is used here, base, what will happen, the base which will abstract the proton from here, now base can abstract the proton over here, and you are going to get the product, this type of the intermediate over there, C double bond O, then this one, let us see X over there, and here the carbanion R3 R4, and the here is R1 and R2 as it is. Now this carbanion, look at this structure carefully, this negative charge is going to attack on this carbon atom, and there is a departure of that halide group over here, and the intermediate form cyclopropanone is like this, is a specialty of this Fieruski rearrangement reaction, R1 R2, and then here should be R3 and the R4, they are as it is. Now when that cyclopropanone intermediate is formed, now here the hydroxyl group OH is going to attack on that carbonyl carbon, and this electrons are revolving around that carbonyl group, retain as it is, and these get opened over there, and the resulting compound obtained will be this one, R1, R2R, R3. Now I opening from this, so you can open this side also, so that you will get this type of the product R. Then here is R1, R2. Then here should be C double bond OH carboxylic group, and this should be the R3 and the R4. So this is the general product we are going to getting in this particular case. Understood this reaction carefully. Look at this reaction once again carefully. When it is treated with base, we are getting this type of the carboxylic acid as an final product. When you look at the mechanism, how we can get this product, the mechanism gives you the clear cut idea about this product. Okay, so this is one of the example. Let me give one more example over there, where the you can get more and more idea regarding this Fibrovsky rearrangement reaction. Now let us see over here another example which is given in the book. So let us see that example over here. This is once again is a cyclopropanone. Then here is a R compound is given, R, and then not this one. Let us see, not this one. Let me clear the example over here. So this is the example where chlorine atom is given over there, and then C double bond O, and here is a methyl group. So that type of the starting compound they have given, and where you have to when the mechanism this will be treated with any suppose as a alkoxide like RO minus alkoxide. This is called as alkoxide, alkoxide which is also as a base, and the resulting compound obtained will be this one, C double bond O, OR, and then this R must be there. So this type of product, this one is a methyl group, so you should write here is a methyl group. So you should get this type of the product. How we are getting, and now you are familiar with this Fibrovsky rearrangement reaction. Now you can predict the product perfectly by knowing the mechanism. Let me give you the mechanism once again, how we are getting this type of the product over here. Instead of hydroxyl as a nucleophile, we have taken alkoxide as an nucleophile, and the product we are getting as an ester. Now let us look over here, let us observe this structure while writing as a mechanism over there. Chlorine atom, then C double bond O, and now is a CS3, right? Now this is the structure which we got over here. Now this is alpha chlorine atom having as over here is a chlorine atom can abstract the proton from here, because this is a carbonyl group. Remember here, adjacent to the carbonyl group, whatever alpha hydrogen atoms are there, this is alpha position, this is also as alpha position, right? Now the chlorine atom not at this position, let me alpha halo ketone must be there. So let us make the correction over there. So here chlorine should be at alpha position, so here must be the chlorine atom. Now this chlorine atom at alpha position opposite to that alpha, so that alkoxide RO minus will pick up the proton from here for sake of convenience. I am writing one of the proton is like this. So OR minus will pick up the proton from here, form as a carbanion, and we are going to get the product over here. Then this one Cl double bond O CH 2 minus charge, that the carbanion adjacent to the carbonyl group is well stabilized due to the resonance effect, and this negatively charge is going to attack on this carbonyl group, on this carbon atom bearing the chlorine atom, and that chlorine atom get depart, and the cyclopropanone derivative is intermediate will be obtained in this particular case. Cyclopropanone derivative or the intermediate obtained, and this intermediate is highly unstable. Here the alkoxide is alkoxide RO minus is going to attack. Here again is a question where it can attack. There are two sides are there. One is this side and another one is the same. And I already told you at the beginning of this Pivrovsky rearrangement reaction, some of the selectivity or the stereoselective reaction is obtained. Stereoselective means what? We are getting only and one product. So that alkoxide act as an nucleophile. It preferentially attacking on the less substituted side. So this is going to attack on that carbonyl group. Let me show you clearly. This alkoxide is going to attack here. R O minus attacking on this carbonyl group, and then this ring get open, and you are going to get the product should be this one. Let this 6-membered ring, it is as it is. Then here C double bond O O R, and this methyl group it must be there. So this is the product which we got over here. So look at this mechanism carefully once again, and you can understood how the Pivrovsky reaction, or the when there is application, these are the some of the application. Example is nothing but as a application of this particular rearrangement reaction. Always remember while writing in the mechanism or while solving the problem based on this Pivrovsky rearrangement reaction, example is nothing but as an application of that particular rearrangement reaction. So I think you might have get clear idea about this. Now let us look at as one more example over there, and from that you can understood the Pivrovsky reaction more and more more in detail by studying these number of examples. So different example we have studied, but the main principle how the mechanisms are occurs, and from where, from which side the nucleophile is attacking. Nucleophile are two kind of the nucleophile we generally employing in this reaction. One either hydroxyl group or alkoxides are there. And if you use as a hydroxyl group, resulting product obtained will be the carboxylic compound, and when you are using alkoxide, the resulting final product obtained will be the ester group. And now let us look, let us see another example over there. Now we are talking learning as a examples over here. C double bond O, then here the example, let me write these examples over there, and this again is a chlorine atom. Now it will be treated with the base, generally sodium NaH, that is also as a what we can call it as a sodium sodium hydride, and then it is used with that amides. Generally amide is used as a methyl amines like this, this one CH3 then NH2. This is the compound which is used over there, and by using this one we can get the product is like this, a C double bond O, NH and the NH and the methyl group O there, this one. This type of the product is obtained. So by knowing as a mechanism, we can able to write that Fieruski rearrangement reaction. I think with this, by studying as a number of example of this compound PHCH2A, not this, there is a PHCH2NH2. This is a benzylamine is used over there, and you are getting as a this type of the product CH2 and then pH over here. So that is the product. The mechanism again is the same whatever we have seen so far. I think with this we have completed the Fieruski rearrangement reaction. In the next lecture we will see the, I think so far we have seen number of rearrangement reaction such as Beckmann rearrangement reaction, Curtius rearrangement reaction, Schmidt rearrangement reaction, then Pinakolan rearrangement. These are the different reaction we have seen. Then Clazene rearrangement reaction also we have, Clazene rearrangement reaction, which is a last reaction in this particular chapter or at this TYBS level syllabus included. That we will see in the next lecture. So let us stop today here. Remaining we will see in the next lecture. Thank you. Have a nice day.